Stimulus Lighthouse Alert Neighborhood Presents, Emily Murphy, GSA Administrator. 5 Fast Realities You Need to Know. Emily Murphy is a General Services Administration, GSA, employee in charge of signing the papers that will allow Joe Biden's presidential shift team to begin work this week, but she's declining to sign those documents. As the GSA Administrator, among Murphy's jobs is to sign an official letter allowing the shift process to begin, from one presidency to the next. This letter supplies countless dollars of resources to the transition group for the next president. It offers government gain access to and clearance to particular members of the transition group, along with office and required equipment. But Murphy has yet to sign the letter. 1. Murphy has been the GSA administrator for 4 years. She was appointed by Trump. Murphy is the GSA administrator, making her the leader of the federal government agency. She was designated to the function by Trump, and sworn in unanimously at the beginning of his presidency, according to her bio. Per her bio, Murphy leads a staff of over 11,000 civil servants. Murphy's refusal to sign the transition papers for the Biden group has enormous ramifications for the procedure, The Washington Post reports. Biden's shift group cannot get official federal government email address till she signs those papers. They do not get access to federal workplaces, and they can't do the needed work of filing papers with the Office of Government Ethics for monetary disclosures and conflict of interest forms. One senior White House main spoke with the paper anonymously about why Murphy may not have actually wished to sign those papers yet. No agency head is going to get out in front of the president on transition concerns today, the authorities described. 2. Murphy has not publicly commented on the transition delay, a GSA spokesperson said. An ascertainment has yet to be made. Lots of people may be questioning whether Murphy is personally refusing to sign the letter for her own expert reasons, or if she's been provided an instruction by the White House. Murphy hasn't offered a public declaration on the matter since Monday, but a representative for the GSA has. For the Washington Post, GSA Representative Pamela Pennington provided the following emailed statements. An ascertainment has actually not yet been made, and its administrator will continue to abide by and fulfill all requirements under the law. Murphy's latest public declaration came 3 days back, in the type of a tweet that had absolutely nothing to do with the governmental election. On her main federal government Twitter account, she tweeted, "Happy National Veteran Small Business Week. #Dyke. The federal government's goal is to award a minimum of 3% of all federal contracting dollars to service-disabled veteran-owned small businesses each year. You can find help from exausbuexa.gov/smallbusiness. 3. Murphy refused to answer questions from Congress about Trump Hotel in D.C. during a hearing in January. In January, Murphy appeared prior to Congress in a hearing for the Trump Hotel in D.C., a USG renter. Murphy repeatedly declined to answer questions about the hotel. When asked if the Trump Hotel had gotten money from foreign federal governments, Murphy replied, "GSA does not have that info." When asked if the hotel breaches the emolument stipulation, Murphy replied, "That problem is still being adjudicated and can't be commented on." When asked why the GSA hadn't privately examined the hotel, Murphy replied, "It's up to each contracting officer." 4. Murphy has served various roles in the GSA since 2005. Prior to her function as GSA administrator, Murphy has actually served a number of other positions in the company during her time there. From 2005 to 2007, she entered the company and held the position of Chief Acquisition Officer. Murphy worked in a number of positions beyond the GSA from 2007 to 2017, consisting of positions in the economic sector and the general public sector. In 2017, Murphy returned to the GSA and acted as the senior advisor to the GSA administrator. Her bio checks out. In that role, she assisted introduce the Centers of Excellence program within the Technology Transformation Services of the Federal Acquisition Service. There are now 15 firms hosting at least one GSA Center of Excellence task. Murphy was eventually promoted to GSA Administrator, where she lives now. 5. Murphy is an alum of the University of Virginia Law School. According to her LinkedIn, Murphy is an alum of Smith College, where she got her undergraduate degree, and the University of Virginia Law School. After graduating from law school in 2001, Murphy worked at Wiley Rain LLP, a law firm concentrating on federal government contracts and affairs. After 3 years practicing law, Murphy got a brand new job at the U.S. Small Business Administration, working as a senior consultant for government agreements and service development.